Hello again, modelers. Welcome back to the Gearhead Workshop. And tonight we have on the bench the brand new kit from Polar Lights, the Klingon Katinga class battlecruiser IKS Amar. My client Gene Davis got me set me up with a pretty good deal on getting this kit, so I figured we'd do a review of this. We're still building his nice and model designs resin 350 Katinga, and we're waiting on some electronics and parts for that, so we'll be getting back to that when we've got more going on with it. I guess I'll give a quick shout out to Stephen Burns at Chrome Illusion. He's doing some custom 3D printed parts for that kit, the resin kit. So if you need any parts, you can look up Stephen Burns on Facebook, Chrome Illusion. And I guess straight off, we got a nice big box here. And we'll open it up here, and we'll kind of start, see if we can go through some of the parts real quick. The box does have box art on the sides with color call-outs for Tamiya and Model Master paints. So these tabs on the box do fold up to give you better views of the ship. And also, I'm going to recommend you can find some decent reference pictures of the Katinga on Modelers Miniatures and Magic under their reference section. So you can go there too and look at some pictures of the actual model. And let's see, what we'll do here is kick the box down on the floor and we'll start pulling out some stuff to take a look at everything. First up, we've got our instruction sheet, which is laid out pretty nice. We've got our assembly instructions go over here at the beginning, just basic modeling stuff that you need to look out for about the decals and sub-assemblies, decals and paint. And they take you through this thing step by step. The bulb itself gets built up as a jig on part of the bridge deck, and we've also got our nice bridge domes here, which we'll show those later. We got an optional part in there in resin for that. It's a little tiny bit more detailed than the plastic part. And Chris over at HPI Guy Workshop pointed this out, and I'm going to point it out too. On step two in the instructions, they call out for part number 11 here. And the part number is actually 121. So you need to be on the lookout for that. And there's also a another thing that came up with this kit. I'll show the part later, but there's a spare part that you're going to get in your kit, and it's a clear part for the comb radiator on the impulse deck here. The part that's on the sprue actually has a bit of a short shot on one of the pins, so you're probably going to find a spare individually bagged in your kit. The one with the short-shotted pin can probably still be used, but you can use the replacement too, either one, or just you can have one as a backup, and say in case you build this without the lighting kit and use the clear part, and you goof and get a little glue on it, so it's a good either way. And we go through the bridge assembly, the whole command deck and everything, and they move on to constructing the boom. And installing the torpedo launcher and some of the details at the base of the boom. And then step four, we start building up our nacelles, which they're basically two halves with a part for lighting and an end cap. It's not a whole lot to them, a couple little detail greeblies on the back, but it's really nice. And then in step five, they're covering the assembly of the entire impulse deck and the upper hangar bay. And then you've got your rear bulkhead with your impulse engines and the torpedo launcher detail, and you have an optional cap for that, so you can cap that off. I'm not sure whether that's a push-in, push-out, removable part, or whether it's a glue-in option, but you do have the option there. And then we get into the main hull construction here, putting that together and putting some of the greeblies and stuff into the bottom and the side vents for the wings. And in step eight, we start putting some more of the greebly details, the rear wing details, installing the rear bulkhead. And then step nine, they have you mounting up your boom, your nacelles, and getting it onto the base. And then step 10, which I think may be the last step, is your installation of your impulse deck and hangar bay, which if you're using the lighting kit, you want to make sure you don't glue that. That's your battery access. And then down here in this lower section is all the greebly details for the front bulkhead, which they are included in plastic. And if you buy the lighting kit, you also get the option of using photo etch for all those details. So that's pretty cool. And you also get the optional photo etch to do your window lighting on the bulb and the command bridge deck. And I think that's pretty much it for the instructions. Just wanted to go through those real quick. So we'll start pulling some parts and whatnot out and looking at those. I guess first thing I'll cover is these are your stock kit clear parts. And this here, this curved piece, is the misnumbered part in the instructions. Like I said, it calls out in the instructions, it says part number 11. It's actually part 121. So you want to be aware of that when you're building the kit. And we've got this is the part that there's a duplicate for, the clear part for the comb impulse deck grill. And this is the spare part that you're going to find in the kit with the full pins on it. So you just want to be aware that guy's floating around in there, and you'll know what that's for. We've already kind of gone over that with Jamie Hood from round two. And let's see. Next up, we'll pop these out of the bag. These are going to be your bridge domes, which I'll see if I can kind of get one of these up in the camera. But you get the stock kit part and a slightly more detailed one in casted resin. Let's see if we can, I don't know if that's really coming through on the camera, but that's the resin detailed one. It's really nice. It's got some really, really small greeblies on it that aren't on the plastic one. So it's an option. You can use a kit part or you can use this one, either one. And let's see, we'll move away from these and start getting into some other stuff. Take a look at the decals next. The decals are really sweet. Really nice quality. I don't know if it's gonna come through on the camera, but this yellowish part and the torpedo detail, that's actually in like an orange goldish yellow metallic, and it looks really cool in person. And they give you some of your Klingon script, your trefoil, and decals for your windows that can be, I'm assuming, used on the kit or on the photo etch. So that's your decals. And let's see, next we'll start pulling out some of these monsters. First of all, we'll take a look at this real quick. They give you a nice base for it. It's your standard large style polar lights base with the steel pole. So you'll have a nice stand to go with it. Or since the lighting kit's self-contained, if you use the lighting kit, you can also you can hang this thing. So it's a choice, you know, a base for hanging. And start going through some of these sprues here. Pull them out of the bag. This is one sprue. We got a lot of parts going on. Some of these parts here are some of the details for the front bulkhead, along with some of these. We've got your front of your command bridge. There's a detail that goes underneath of the boom. And the side pieces for your impulse deck, which have the cutouts for the wing lamps. And we've got some parts of the bulb here with the windows already cut out. They're really small, but they're there. And we've got a lower detail piece for the boom part of the bridge up here, which the greebly details on this thing are really nice. They're really crisp. I mean, Jamie Hood and Charles Adams over at Polar Lights really knocked this thing out of the park with the detail. And it's really pretty darn accurate. It's the most accurate representation I've seen of any of these kits, resin or the older kits that were out of it. And you got your back of your hanger bay and the main parts of the bulb up here. So we'll move along here and get through the rest of these parts. And next up, we got the upper part of the command bridge, which again we've got some really nice small greebly details on there, and on the side vents that go on the sides here. We've got our impulse deck radiators. And on both sides here, we've got the rear detail for the wings with some nice vent detail in there, and some nice, really nice greebly detail down inside of here, recessed. We've got our command bridge tower hash, another part to the impulse deck and the main impulse deck here. And over here we've got another part of the bulb, and this is your torpedo launcher tube. And we've got the main boom in the lower part of the bulb, or the onion as some people like to call it. And all this stuff looks really great. Really great stuff. And let's see, we've got a couple more sprues to go through here, and then we'll get to the main hull. So we've got one sprue left here. What we got here is your main nacelle parts, four halves for your nacelles. We've got some more detail over here that go on the sides of the boom. The rear bulkhead area with your impulse engines and the torpedo launcher tube for the rear firing torpedo. And we've got some really nice grill detail for the front of the wings. And this is a detail that goes on the bottom of the hull. And we've got our main grills for the impulse drive, and the detail on the bottom of these is really great. Really nice, sharp, crisp detail going on there. And we've got our other part to our impulse deck cover that goes on the top of the hull there. And I think that's it for the sprues. So what's left is we'll take a look at the main hull halves. Now, first one, this is the lower hull half. And I said it already, I can't say enough about the job they did on the detail on this kit. It really blows away anything else that's been out there of the Katinga. The panel lines and everything, and all the details, really crisp and sharp. I mean, get a look at the front bulkhead there. We got a lot of holes in there for all the little greebly details that go in there. It's going to look really great. Really good details going to be happening on this kit. And we've got another part to our command bridge. This is the lower half that goes underneath of the bridge deck. And let's see, lastly for the parts, we've got our upper hull. And same thing, all the feather detail and everything on this is really freaking great. I mean, it blows me away, the job they did on this. And we've got another part here to the back section of our command bridge. And once again, the detail there is just really great, and it's about the most accurate you're going to get for a Katinga kit. And in here is where your battery and your lighting board will be contained. You'll have to excuse my phone, it's dinging in the background. I guess we all know what that's like. And I guess that's it for the parts to the kit or the Katinga. And we've also got the light kit that we're going to go through pretty quick here. This is also available from Polar Lights, and it's a self-contained lighting kit. We've got a 3 AA battery box, which will run your lighting at about 4.5 volts, and everything's pretty much plug and play. You've got like a JST style plugs that all your light strings plug right into this board, and the whole thing goes right down into that impulse deck, and you can pop the hatch and turn your lighting on and off. And in this bag, we've got all the LEDs. I believe there's 27 LEDs total. And everything's all pre-wired, labeled, you know, so for easy install, you refer to your build instructions and the instructions that come for the light kit, because this lighting has to be installed as you build sub-assemblies, so you really want to make sure you cross-reference as you build with the lighting kit instructions to make sure you're putting your lighting in when you need to put it in. Or you're going to be a bad way if you skip that. So the other thing that's in the light kit is you get these clear red parts. Some of them you may not want to use, but most of them you will. Just a quick look. These parts here you may not want to use if you want to be kind of screen accurate. These are for window panel detail in the front bulkhead. And you could use these and make them red, but I'm pretty sure the original Katinga, they were white. And these are your impulse grills and your torpedo detail. And the red clear part to do your bridge windows and the bridge tower. And this is the optional part for the comb impulse deck grid. to light that up red, and you've got some other small little details over here in red that can be used in optional places, or they may be required. It just depends on how you want to build your kit, whether you want it screen accurate or whether you want to play around with some options and adding some red lights here and there. And the other thing we got in here is the photo etch, which these bands are for to do your window lighting if you want to use photo etch and sharpen up the window holes. This goes around the onion, the bulb of the command bridge, and these are for the forward command bridge trenches in the front. And the other stuff that's around here, over here, here, and across here are some of the photo etch details that go about the base of the boom as it enters the main hull. And it's really nice stuff. You've got to do a little bending on some of this stuff, but they give you instructions on how to do that in the lighting kit. So if you've never done it before, it's not too bad. You're just going to need some tweezers or a photo etch bender, and you'll be all in business with that. And I think that's about it for the lighting kit, except real quick, we'll take a quick peek at the instruction layout. Basically, what you're going to get is a layout of where everything goes, and they give you a call out to explain what everything is, the sizes of the LEDs, the male and female plugs, the letter code for the wiring bundle where each one goes, and part numbers. And there's also a detail on a little mod you have to do to set up the lighting box for the comb radiator on the impulse deck. But that's not anything major. It's basically removing two parts and gluing them on to your main impulse deck part, and then assembling the lens and the bottom piece that's the LED holder. And I think you also get a layout of all the wiring bundles, just for reference. And over here we have the instructions for the photo etch on how to bend some of the detail parts, and a basic layout of where they go, and how to do the overlays for the windows on the command bridge and the bulb, the onion. And you can also reference the kit box or reference pictures online for placement of some of those detail parts. So I guess before we go, we'll give another shout out to Jamie Hood and Charles Adams over at Polar Lights for bringing everybody this kit. And another shout out to Stephen Burns, if you want to get into any, maybe doing some custom 3D printed parts for this to do your own version, just look up Stephen Burns on Facebook, Chrome Illusion. And I'm also going to mention too, Cameron Randall Lewis from Cameron's Decals and such. You can find him at www.cameronsdecals.com. He's going to have full painting mask sets for this hopefully by the end of the week. So if you're interested in some paint masks, you can look him up at that website, www.cameronsdecals.com, and get put on the list or order a set. And I guess for this look over the new Polar Lights Klingon Katinga, that's going to be about it. And I guess stay tuned. We're going to later be back into the Nissen Models 350 Katinga in resin. And also a quick shout out to on Facebook, there is a group. It's the 1/350 scale Klingon Katinga only tips and tricks page. And I'm going to be building up this kit later. And I'll probably be posting some, I guess you'd say, tips or tricks on anything I may come up with to make the kit a little better. Mainly, I think what I'm going to experiment with is trying to see what we can get out of the lighting kit over the way it comes out of the box. I'm probably going to work with, some diffusion techniques and stuff like that to see if we can, kick it up a little bit. So, until the next video, whatever that may be, everybody take care, happy modeling, and peace.